Into P2, you're currently on the front row of the grid. When you're ready, let's go. Two laps of fuel remaining. We'll be right back. than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty. Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 18.8. Checks complete. All personnel be aware, we have a car leaving.
And with qualifying complete, Let's review our top three today.
Hamilton,
Leclerc,
and Sebastian Vettel. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. Welcome one and all, and we're in for a real treat at this classic circuit here today. The crowd are ready to go, the cars are ready to go, and we're just about set for Lights Out. Welcome to the Italian Grand Prix. With top speeds up to 215 miles per hour and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1, so how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Vettel, Bottas, Max Verstappen, and Norris, Ocon, Sainz, Albon, and Daniel Ricciardo, Perez, Giovinazzi, Daniel Kvyat, and Raikkonen, Stroll, Gasly, Romain Grosjean, and Kevin Magnussen, Russell, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. Not expecting any changes to the weather today. Dry throughout. rest of the grid is forming up, be patient and watch for the lights. First lap, keep it up. DRS, DRS now available. In first place. target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. We lost the position. Try to keep focus. We expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Understood, stopping this lap. Carlos is in the pits. Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Go, go, go. After these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. boxed for the mediums, car behind on the medium tyre. The gap to the car behind is 2.1 seconds. P10, you've moved up into P10. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. We'll be right back. were leading our teammate by 10.6 seconds. Out in front. This is your final lap, final lap of the race. Front is 3.2 seconds. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
There it is then. Victory in the Italian Grand Prix. An historic race and an achievement they can be immensely proud of. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day, and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace, and our winner today showed they could do both.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Interesting choice today, I think. There's a few to pick from, but I think I have to give it to Danny Kvyat. He put in a rock-solid performance today, and one that he can be proud of.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.